electric field intensity. With the help of electric field intensity, we can explain the behavior of the electric field quantitatively, how strong it is, how weak it is. What is the definition of electric field intensity? The force acting on a unit positive charge is called electric field intensity. Let us consider this is the charge. Now, around this one, there is an electric field. Now, the charge is located at this point O. Field is produced due to this charge, therefore, this is called source charge. In this field, consider any point. At this point, or at this point, at this point, or at this point. Let us consider there is a point P. What is the line joining between these two? This is the line joining between. What is the distance between these two? Let us consider R. At that point P, what is the effect of electric field? That effect can be explained through electric field intensity. Put the unit positive charge here. Then no doubt it will experience a force. This charge, this unit positive charge will experience a force by this source charge. The force experienced by the unit positive charge, which is placed at any point, is called electric field intensity at that point. Now, what is the formula? Now, E is equals to F by, what to say, Q naught. Q naught is called a test charge. Now this is a source charge. Q naught is the test charge. What is my test charge? Unit positive charge. Therefore Q naught is equals to plus 1 coulomb. E is equals to F by Q naught is equals to 1. Therefore E is equals to, what do you say, F. The force experienced by the test charge, the force experienced by the unit positive charge at any point is called electric field intensity at that point. Now, what is the formula for electric field intensity? E is equals to F by Q naught. Next one. This electric field intensity is a vector quantity. It has both magnitude and direction, and it will obey laws of vector addition. Electric field intensity is a vector quantity. It has a magnitude, it has a direction, and it will obey the laws of vector addition. Next, what are the units? E is equals to F by Q naught. Force unit is Newton. Q naught is the test charge. Is nothing but charge. Charge unit is coulomb. Therefore, Newton per coulomb is the unit of electric field intensity. Now, suppose with the help of electric field intensity, what is the uniform electric field? What is the non-uniform electric field? If the electric field intensity is same both in magnitude and direction at every point in the electric field, is the uniform electric field. What is the non-uniform electric field? Electric field intensity, magnitude may change, direction may be changed, or both are changed, then such a field is called non-uniform electric field. Electric fields are two types, already I told you earlier. Uniform electric field is there, non-uniform electric field is. What is a uniform electric field? What is a non-uniform electric field? If the electric field intensity is same, both in magnitude and direction, at every point in the electric field, is called uniform electric field. What is a non-uniform electric field? The magnitude of the electric field at every point, either magnitude changes or direction changes, both are changed, then it is called non-uniform electric field. For example, this is a uniform electric field. Uniform electric field. Now at this point, let us consider electric field intensity 10 newton per coulomb. Here is also 10 newtons 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 per coulomb. In this field, at every point, magnitude of the electric field 10 newton per coulomb, direction is also same. Then such a field is called uniform electric field. In the non-uniform electric field, let us consider this is a field. Here 10 newton per coulomb. Here that is 15 newton per coulomb. Right? Here 18 newton per coulomb. Right? In this case, even though direction is same, magnitude of the field intensity is changed. Then it is called non-uniform electric field. Sometimes direction is different, magnitude is same. Again it is non-uniform electric field. Sometimes magnitude is different as well as direction is also different. Then such a field is called non-uniform electric field. Next one. Suppose there is an electric field. What is the strength of the electric field? E. Electric field is there. In that electric field, let us consider a charge Q is placed. Let us consider Q naught is the charge is placed. What will happen? What will happen? It will experience a force according to the this formula, force by enthalpy. Q naught. Therefore, F bar is equals to E Q naught. A charge Q naught is placed in the uniform electric field, then it will experience a force. F is equals to E Q. Therefore, this is a formula. There is a electric field E naught. In that electric field, a charge is placed Q naught. What will happen? It will experience a force. Let us consider what is the mass. M is the mass. As it is experiencing the force, according to the Newton's second law, M A is equals to E Q naught. Therefore, A bar is equals to E Q naught by M. The charge Q naught of mass M is placed in the uniform electric field. No doubt it will experience a force. According to the Newton's law, second law, it will experience a force. Means it has the acceleration F is equals to ma. Right? Here, if it is a positive charge, right? That charge will move in the direction of the field. If it is a negative charge, the charge will move opposite to the direction of electric field. If Q naught, whatever we are placing, is a positive charge, it will move in the direction of the field. Q naught is the charge, which is a negative charge, it will move opposite to the electric field. Now, electric field intensity. Electric field intensity with respect to different cases we can calculate electric field intensity. Due to the point charge, what is the electric field intensity? Due to the electric dipole, what is the field intensity? Due to the distribution of the charge, what is the electric field intensity? Now, in a particular case, the electric field intensity due to a point charge. Electric field intensity due to a point charge. Electric field intensity due to a point charge. Now there is a point charge Q. This is called source charge. Around this one there is an electric field. At this point, what is the electric field intensity? Right? Already electric field intensity is equals to F by, what do you say, Q naught. Force experienced by the unit positive charge. Force experienced by the test charge. Now let us consider, this is called O point. This is called, what do you say, P point. What is the distance between these two? R is the distance between these two. Let us consider, here I am placing a test charge. Here I am placing, what to say, Q naught is the test charge. There is a charge Q, there is a charge Q naught. Charge Q is placed at point O. Charge Q naught is placed at the point P. What is the separation? R is the separation. Between these two, there is a force. Let us consider, this is a positive charge. Again, this is the test charge is also positive. This Q charge will apply force on the Q naught charge. Q naught charge will apply force on the Q charge. Right? Now, the Q charge will apply force on the Q naught charge. Let us consider F. Right? That F is equals to, what is the force? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. What is the general formula? That is Q1 into Q2 by R square. Therefore, F is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1. Q1 is equals to Q. Q2 is the test charge by R square. Therefore, F by Q0 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R square. The force experienced by the test charge, as we know, electric field intensity is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R square. Now, this is in a scalar form. Right, let us consider the same 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R square. Next, it is multiplied by a unit vector R cap. Then this is called, what to say, electric field intensity. It is in the form of unit vector, but we know that right unit vector R cap is equals to R bar by, that is R. Now in this case, E bar is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R square into R cap. R cap is equals to R bar by R. Therefore, E cap is equals to, this is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by, that is R square into R, R cap, R cube into R bar. Right? And there is a formula. there is a formula. Electric field intensity 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square, which is a scalar form. Electric field intensity 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square into r cap, it is a unit vector form. But unit vector r cap is equals to r bar by r, e bar is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square r cap instead of r cap r bar by r. Therefore, E bar is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r cube into r bar. This is the equation in the unit vector form. This is the equation in the vector form. Right? Generally, we are using this formula. Scalar form only we can use. Now, in the various problems, we can use the vector form also. Now, here in this case, in air or vacuum, air or vacuum, that is E is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r square. In any medium, right, E is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 1 by k into q by r square. Here there is a term k. K is called dielectric constant or relative permittivity. Now, these are the formulae of electric field intensity due to the point charge. Here, electric field intensity is inversely proportional to square of the distance. Distance is increased, electric field intensity is decreased. Distance is decreased, electric field intensity is increased. Now, electric field intensity E1 by E2 is equals to what to say R2 square by that is R1 square. Distance is decreased by 2 times. Distance is decreased by 2 times. 2 square 4. Electric field intensity increased by 4 times. Distance is decreased by 3 times. 3 square 9. Electric field intensity increased by 9 times. Therefore, E1 by U2 is equals to R2 square by R1 square. This is the most useful formula.